We had a great question come in about hand placement in side angle pose and also in triangle pose. And the question has to do with what's the difference between having your hand or your arm inside the front leg in these poses versus outside the front leg? And I think this is a really good question. So Cora submitted this question and she asked, I have a question on how the hand placement in side angle pose and triangle pose may change the difficulty and the pelvis and spine alignment. In classical poses, we have the hand outside of the front leg in side angle and triangle, while in many modern yoga classes, the hand is inside of the front leg. We would also put the hand in front if we were preparing for binds. So like an arm bind, yeah, we would have the arm inside in order to bind. And then she also says, now I am being told that hand inside of the front foot is easier than outside. So my questions are, is it true? Like meaning, is it true that hand inside is easier than hand outside? How does putting the hand inside or outside of the front foot change the position of the pelvis or the spine? And how do we make the choice of where we place the hand? So really good questions. And I do think that our hand and our arm placement in those poses can make a difference. I don't think it's the hugest difference, but I do think that it can make a difference. So this is a good detail to break down. I, first of all, would just want to highlight the fact that we can move our arm separately from the rest of our torso. I know this is pretty obvious, but like we can move the arm without also moving our spine. So for example, we could, let's see if I just demo it this way. We could be in, say we're in side angle pose. I could just move my arm outside or my arm inside without also moving the rest, like not moving my chest along with the arm. And in that case, if I just did this, that really would not be much of a difference either way because I'm not moving the chest along with the arm. So it is possible to like compare the two. And if you don't actually move everything else, then there's not really gonna be much of a tangible difference. But we're kind of thinking, and I know Cora's question is like assuming that if the arm goes inside, then of course, then the chest would come along and the spine would come along. And if the arm were outside, then the spine would also come along. So that's what this question is about. And let's see if we could kind of decipher this a little bit with our movement eyes. So when we're in these poses, we know that we are in a position of hip abduction, external rotation, and then hip flexion. So like, let's say it's side angle, then we have this front knee bent. And if it's triangle, then the leg is straight. So when we're talking about like the difficulty of these poses, as we've talked about, the main like biomechanical demand, well, mobility wise would be the hip joint position in that front hip. And it's like, it's positioned into external rotation. With side angle pose, because we have this knee bent, we have another biomechanical demand, which would be like the quads working and that kind of effort that's happening, that muscular effort. But in Cora's question here, I see it as pertaining more to the mobility demand in this front hip versus like the quads in like that the amount that's being worked there, because arm inside, arm outside is not going to have much if any difference on that biomechanical demand is in the effort and the work inside angle. So I'm looking at this more about that front hip joint position and the position that it's in. So we're in a position as we come into either one of these poses. We've got, you know, external rotation, flexion, abduction happening. And the idea is that it's mobilizing for the hip in that position so that we're pretty much like in our end range position of that hip so that we can mobilize, create a little more range of motion, et cetera. So if that's the biomechanical demand, you know, that we're thinking about here, then the question is, does the arm inside or outside, how does that affect what's happening at the hip? So I know it can be a little tricky when we're like in the pose, we're down in the pose and like, what is the difference here? If the arm goes inside, I do kind of turn the chest more this way. This is gonna rotate the rest of my spine and my pelvis this way. And if my arm goes this way, then everything will turn down a little bit. So I think that it could be a little helpful for our movement eyes to see if I come up out of, you know, being down in the pose. And instead, let's just come up and stand. And let's say I'm going over this leg here. So this movement of arm forward and then the chest coming along, or arm outside and the chest coming along, it's this movement in this plane. So my spine is rotating, my pelvis is also coming along. So it's like the arm moves and then my spine and pelvis all turn this way if the arm goes inside. And if the arm is outside, all of this turns this way a little bit. So we know these are positions of external rotation in the front hip. You know, the femur articulates with the pelvis in the acetabulum in the hip socket. So movement of the thigh will affect the position of the hip joint, but movement of the pelvis will also affect the position of the hip joint. And if I'm, you know, in some external rotation here, if my whole pelvis turns this way, rotates this way, and this is what would happen if we're talking about like arm outside the front leg. So compared to inside, if we go outside, everything turns this way, my pelvis turns this way a little bit. So when that happens, this rotation of the pelvis, that will reduce the external rotation in the front hip joint. It's less external rotation the more forward the pelvis is. And the more that the pelvis is side facing, the more external rotation is happening in this hip. And this may make sense if we think back to our videos and the way we covered triangle pose and side angle and warrior two and all these side facing poses. We talked about how nobody really has 90 degrees of external rotation in their front hip. So even though the foot points forward, it's an illusion to think that that's 90 degrees in the hip joint because we don't have that much range. And so in order to embody the pose and make the pose happen, our pelvis will rotate forward a little bit. This is what we talked about in these poses in general. In order to make space so that we can embody like foot pointing forward, the pelvis will rotate forward a little bit because this will back us out of the external rotation on this front hip. Because external rotation is a combination of where the femur is, where the thigh, and also where the pelvis is. So in triangle and side angle, we have a little bit of this forward pelvis to back out of external rotation so that we can turn the front foot forward. So it's like this exact same movement that comes into play with Cora's question about arm inside or arm outside. When the arm is outside, assuming that, you know, the chest, the spine, and the pelvis follow along, that is the equivalent of inviting a little less external rotation in this front hip. It like backs us out a little bit, and therefore arm outside should be a little quote easier. If by easier we mean we're reducing the biomechanical demand of coming into our end range of hip external rotation in that front hip. So arm outside is a little less of a mobility demand on the front hip. Now, you know, like I said, I don't think it's a huge difference either way, but it certainly is a little less of a demand to have the arm outside. And then it's a little more of a demand to bring the arm inside, because when the arm comes inside, let's say it's triangle pose now. So here's outside. If the arm comes inside and everything else comes along with that, you know, my chest and spine and pelvis, then do you see how this is moving the pelvis more toward a stacked position? It's not totally stacked because it can't be, but it's moving it in that direction. So this is increasing the external rotation in the hip joint and moving us further into the range of motion here. Whereas if the arm is outside, everything turns down a little bit, not a lot. We're still mainly in the frontal plane. It's still side facing, but we turn down a little bit. That made a little bit more space. And so arm outside would be just a little bit less demanding. So that's how I would sum up that difference.